We're back with Natalia Sokolova, managing partner of SGG World's Sokol Family Office. And Natalia, like, you have a wild background of coming from the former Soviet Union, ending up in North America as basically a young teenager, mm-hmm. car accident, in a wheelchair, fighting through that. Playboy Playmate, what, 1999? Yeah, so if you want to look it up, there it is. And that has led you, originally you probably figured you were going to have like this business career, and maybe be involved in as an athlete, which took you on a different path. Today, you're now at the leading edge of this whole idea of gamification. And just describe that for me again. It's video gaming in everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so the gamification is about engagement of customers and clients and kids, creating consumer engagement. How do you interact with your audience and making it fun for them? It's about data, it's collecting data, it's about creating experiences, and it's about changing the world.
So, and as technology has advanced in gaming, gaming has always had its pull and appeal, mm-hmm. ever since we started playing Pong. Like, I'm old enough to remember Pong. And now, as it's advanced and as technology is going like this, it's like no wonder mm-hmm. kids are attracted to the gaming world. Mm-hmm. And yet you're saying the average serious gamer is in their 30s.
Yeah. When I first saw it, actually, I was quite surprised by the statistics myself. But because I think that most of the kids enjoyed gaming, like some of them. I mean, I'm not a gamer, but my son is. But it was not popular. So people who were, my age when growing up, there was my cousin played games, but it was just a hobby. So that stayed with them their life. We didn't ever talk about it. So now when they're like in the 30s or, the late 20s, 30s, early 40s, they're still game. But now it's becoming more official. That's their childhood passion that they had before. And I was like, oh my God, I can actually make it not just a childhood passion, I can actually probably make money doing it.
So gaming for good is a catchphrase that I think touches your heart.
Yeah, gaming is a force for good, yes.
Yeah, so talk to me about that.
So I think that, through my career, I was I was always been an entrepreneur, so I ran several successful companies from very early 20s. And I started off with online marketing, so I understand how the bubble and the boom and everything works and what differentiates, what's bubble. But in any case, internet, it started off as people think it was just a bubble where it is right now. We can't imagine our lives without our devices.
It was not a fad.
Same thing is going to happen with blockchain. It's people think it's a bubble. Fast forward 5-10 years later, we're not going to survive our daily lives without blockchain technology.
Natalia, former Playboy Playmate, what the heck is blockchain? Explain it to me. Hopefully you can simplify it for me.
So, simplifying, let's say we're sitting and there's, a few people in the room, right? And I decide that, okay, anything I decide to give you, let's say $100, right? Before, usually you go and you have somebody that you have to verify that the transaction has been done, or a middle person or attorney, especially if it has to do with, buying a property or any kind of transaction. Right now, blockchain, what it does, it's a chain of blocks. So it's create a block that's supported by other people are confirming it. So if we're in the room, you have four people sitting there, check, check, check. Yeah, you guys decided, it's verified. Block is complete. To create a block in the first place, different programmers, miners, are competing against each other to solve a very complex program. So it's very difficult to create a block. So once a block is created, the one transaction goes into one block, which, it's a traditional ledger, but being distributed around hundreds of millions of computers around the world. So it's a verified transaction. You erase middleman, you erase the cost of the middleman. It's done almost instantaneously between different parts of the world. If you're sending money from United States, somebody is working here to their family in Africa, it can be done instantaneously and you can track it exactly where it's going. So right now, it's a lot of technologies come a little bit before the world is ready for them. So I think that happened in this case as well. But you know, right now, JP Morgan is doing it squared. And 3 years.
Doing a
which? JP Morgan?
Yes.
JP Morgan coin.
A coin. Yeah. JP Morgan coin.
And, you know, the CEO of JP Morgan 3 years ago said, I will never ever do anything in blockchain and cryptocurrency and everything is crazy. And here you go. They're doing it only for their institutional, very select customers. So it's their internal private blockchain. And there's difference. Blockchain can be private, can be public, or can be combined. But it's the most secure way to transact anything and to track the origin of any paperwork or any product, let's say blood diamond, right? You want to buy a diamond and you don't, and you're very conscious that where it came from. Mm-hmm. With blockchain, you can track exactly where it came from, each person will be each block. And the best part, you cannot alter any blocks. That's not possible because in order to try to alter each blocks, you have to solve the coding and you have to basically compete against all the computing power of the miners. And it's not just one computer, it's a million computers. So it makes the transaction information very secure.
You're convinced blockchain is here to stay, mm-hmm. cryptocurrency. Oh.
So blockchain is technology.
Yes.
Cryptocurrency is digital currency based on blockchain technology.
It becomes possible because of blockchain.
It becomes possible. I'm very big advocate of the technology. Any kind of cryptocurrency is still speculation. My approach to life is not speculative. So, I mean, Bitcoin went from 20,000 to like under 4,000 right now. There's so many other platforms. I'm not going to be discussing that because I don't know what's going to happen with cryptocurrency.
Right.
I'm sure it's going to be one that's going to prevail eventually or something between the banks to avoid. But blockchain technology is definitely here to stay. It's the matter of when, not if. It's definitely going to be a very important technology go, 5-10 years down the road.
Just want to touch briefly before we let you go again about the WHAM network. Mm. So this is like basically like a television network, mind you, who knows what that means anymore with all the different ways to deliver television. But this is basically the MTV for the gaming world.
Yes.
Out of California. And where are we at with that company?
So WHAM was founded by experiential marketer Greg Kleiman when he saw several thousand, like 20, 30,000 in Madison, basically Madison Square Garden being completely sold out for two nights to watch some girl, teenage, playing video game.
Unbelievable. Yeah.
And that was 3 years ago.
Now, mind you, I feel the same way about these dart shows from the UK, too. But anyway, I digress. So he saw
And he's like, well, it's not just about gaming. It's about lifestyle. It's about, communities, about interactions. And so he started digging deeper. And, fast forward 2 years, a year later, actually, they did a really good job of making it's very in a short time. So May last year, the company went live from the very, inception point. On end of November, it went live on many platforms such as, Comcast, Roku's, Pluto's. And they have absolutely no lack of companies and distribution platform coming to them. We want to have them on our platform. So right now they are in many, many countries around the world, distribution. But what makes them very special is very unique, which is kind of surprising that nobody else did it. It's MTV for gaming. It's one central digital media platform. So you have, obviously Twitch, who was sold for $800 million to Amazon, but it's only streamers, So you're streaming, you're playing, you're streaming. A day later, this content is irrelevant. It's completely gone. With WHAM, it's about lifestyle. So they do a TV show about life of a gamer. Let's say you're an attorney representing a gaming company and you do behind the scenes or like a cooking show when you cook and talk. So it's something that stays in the content that can be reused many times. That's what attracts a lot of people. They do partner with Twitch, so the WHAM is on the Twitch and vice versa. The company, say the biggest one for esports, Jinx out of UK, they only focus on esports. So they're very, very individual and very narrow. So WHAM focuses on everything, and it gives amazing opportunity for, you know, for companies, for people who want to put their message across, to figure out the way to do it through the gamification purpose and create a show behind it. And I think that can be really fascinating because that gives you that highway to get your passion across to so many people who are gaming.
You mentioned passion. It's all over you. And congratulations yes. on your career to date and all the difference you're going to make with gaming for good and all the exciting things that's going to happen with blockchain in our lives. So
thank
you. Natalia Sokolova, thank you so much for joining us on Biz 101.
Thank you, Randy.
Nice to have you.